this is Quinn Banda from WCTV. Another Tech on Street Talk. Again, we are on Onset. I think you remember our contestants from last week. They are here to redeem themselves, right?
Yes, right.
But you said no Red Sox this time.
No Red Sox this time.
But you learned so much from last time.
I did learn, but I didn't know enough in the beginning, though.
No.
But I'm glad I learned.
You remembered two things.
Yeah, Big Poppy, 54 home runs, and I knew Pedro Martinez was inducted into the Hall of Fame, but I didn't say his name last time.
Now you will never forget.
Yeah.
So we're going to be doing Finish That Line.
All right.
Okay, first sentence, first line. We are going to need a bigger
boat. Oh, you're good. Boat.
Oh, yeah.
You have said that they made so many of those movies.
I know they did.
Yeah.
They made too many, I think. First two were good.
Yeah. Okay. Line, sentence number two. Life is like a
bowl of cherries. No?
I have a box of chocolates. But I think
That's from that movie. That's from Forrest Gump.
Yes. Yes. When did you get bowl of cherries?
The original thing was Life is like a bowl of cherries. No, life. I think that's. Many years ago. Yeah.
And white cherries.
I don't know. It was just a saying.
Yeah.
That I used in those cherries.
Oh, okay. All right. Number three. It's one dash dash for man. One dash dash for mankind.
One step for man. Wait a minute. It's on the moon. One.
It is one dash. Dash for man, comma,
man.
One dash dash for mankind.
One. Oh my God, that was.
You were on the track. Moon.
I know
track.
When they were on when John Kennedy was president. One leap. Is it one leap? No.
They're both in there, but we just have to put them in the right
hand. I know it. It's not leap step or step leap. It's not those two together. One leap. Oh, Dan, I know that too. One step. One leap for me. I don't know.
Maybe. But you're on the right.
Yeah.
Oh, you're in the right ballpark.
Yeah.
It's one small step for man.
Yeah.
One giant leap for mankind.
Okay. I had that all mixed.
Yeah.
It's funny.
But at least he knew what was going on in that sentence.
Yeah.
All right. Okay, number four. And we got two right. So we are still in the right ballpark. Number four. 4- and 7 years ago, our fathers brought forth.
Score.
Ooh.
4 score and 7 years ago.
Where was that line from?
4 score and 7 years ago. That would have... That is from the. Oh my God, which one is it from now?
Was it a movie?
No. It was from 4 score and 7 years ago.
4 score and 7 years ago. What was it from?
Gettysburg.
The Declaration of Gettysburg. Independence or the Constitution. Yeah. But I couldn't figure out which one it was,
yeah.
Okay.
Last year in school.
Oh, number five.
I couldn't remember the Gettysburg address.
Right.
I remember that.
Number five. We built this city on and dash. We built this city dash and dash.
We built this
the city on dash and dash.
Rock and
it's
roll?
A song.
Rock and roll?
Oh, we built this city, it's a song. I don't know.
Rock and roll.
Well, you built this city of rock and roll.
Right.
Yeah.
You know that?
Yeah.
All right, Avery.
And rock and roll. Yeah. Have you ever heard of that song?
No.
By Starship.
Oh.
Yeah.
A long time ago band.
But yeah. Very, very good song.
Oh, I forgot.
Yeah. But at least, you did very good. Yeah. What did you? How did you guess that?
Me and my mom were talking about it.
Yeah.
Like 2 weeks ago.
Oh, okay. Oh,
wow.
You guys are a good team.
Yeah.
Okay, so presents time, since you did very well.
Yeah, we got 3 out of
3 out of 5.
How about Mark Anthony's?
Oh, yeah. All right, Avery.
Mark Anthony's. Right.
A gift certificate to Mark Anthony's Pizza.
Yeah.
Thank you so much for participating.
Thank you.
So hello, my name is Dan. I'm one of the assistant camp directors at the Invensys Foxborough YMCA. Today we have our second and third grade camp groups at Onset Beach. They go on field trips once a week. So every Wednesday we have an off-site experience for them to have some fun. Slide. So we keep these guys entertained, active, engaged all day long. Counselors do a fantastic job making sure the experience is amazing for these kids, smiles on faces. So it's been an awesome summer so far. We got a few more weeks left, but so far so good. I've seen a lot of smiling faces on the way home, and the kids are happy. We're loving summer and we can't wait to have more of it. We do up to 11 weeks of summer camp. Individuals can participate in one or as many as all 11. We have different day options for them too. So we have 3 day options, 4 day options. We have experiences for kids that are in kiddie camp or kindergarten age, 3, 4, and 5 year olds. And we go all the way up to our teens where we have opportunities for kids as old as 9th and 10th graders to have a camp experience. You know, I would say it's a little bit of everything. You know, the YMCA, we're a values-based organization, so we try to infuse, you know, proper core values, as we call them, into our experiences daily. So the core four: caring, honesty, respect, responsibility. So in addition to fun, we make sure that we infuse these life lessons, life skills, into what we do with them to make sure they can be successful elsewhere too, not just here at camp, but they have skills that they can bring to school, to friends, to family. We do different team building activities and exercises so they can understand what proper communication is, how we listen, how we work together, how we communicate and make sure that the team is a cohesive unit. So, and you know, the experience differs from younger to older kids, but the message is still the same. We wanna make sure that, you know, our values-based learning and experience and fun is gonna be something that, again, sets them up for success daily, not just at camp, but in all aspects of their life.
Hello, this is Quinn Banda from WCTV, another Tech on Street Talk. With me today is?
Marquise.
And are you still in school?
No.
No?
I graduated from Old Rochester.
Oh, yeah. Congratulations.
Thank you.
Was this year?
No, 2015.
Oh, congratulations. Okay, so you have picked the category of like father, like son. Yeah. And why is that?
It just sounds, I don't know, it fits the description.
Okay.
Sounds easy.
All right. So 5 questions, 3 right.
Okay.
Can we manage that?
Yeah.
Okay.
Try.
So, question number one. These Republican presidents are both still alive today.
Is it George Bush and his father?
Of course. Could you think of any other person?
Nah.
I don't think anybody else goes. No. Well, if Clinton wins, it's gonna be
wife
and husband. Okay, yeah. All right, so one right. I like the spirit. Okay, question number two. The father played for the New Orleans Saints, and two of his sons played for the Colts and the Giants.
Mannings.
Is it the Mannings? Let's see.
Yeah, it is the Mannings.
Oh, it
is the Mannings, the Colts and the Giants.
The Giants and their two brothers.
Yeah, that's Peyton and Eli Manning.
And actually, we didn't put the answer for that.
Yes.
Is it the Mannings?
Yeah.
Okay,
yeah.
See, I don't know that. I don't understand. That's
two.
No, you're making me look bad. Okay, the Mannings, look at you.
Right?
Yeah, all right. I can look at you. Now you're like,
two.
Bring it on.
Let me get the next one.
Okay, number three. Okay, if only the wind could behave. Both making music. The father was shot in 1980, and the son made songs like Too Late for Goodbyes.
Is it Bob Marley and his son, Ziggy Marley? Right?
Bob Marley and Ziggy Marley?
John Lennon?
No. Yeah, Bob Marley wasn't killed. He was shot.
It's okay.
No,
it's okay.
John Legend. Yeah, John Legend played for the Beatles.
Lennon.
Died.
John Lennon.
For the Beatles.
And Julian Lennon.
Yeah, he played for the Beatles. Mm-hmm. They died. Yeah, I didn't know his son.
Okay, that's something you can you learned, right?
Yep, that's
okay.
I learned.
Well, you still have got 2 right, so, and we still have 2 questions left. So question number four. The mother was a character in the horror film Psycho, and the daughter played a character in Halloween. Have you seen the movie Psycho?
No. Halloween. Mm. There was so many of them. I don't know.
Okay, would you like to find out the answer?
Yeah.
Please. Okay. Please.
I don't know that one.
Janet Leigh and Jamie Lee Curtis. Yeah. No.
Only Jamie Lee I remember is Jamie Lee Spears.
James Lee Spears.
Britney Spears' assistant.
Yeah, okay. All right, the last question.
Oh, man. Come on, man, I got faith in you, bro. Okay. Come on, we got there.
The father was in MASH, which was a TV show and also became a movie. Mm-hmm. And the Hunger Games. So it was in MASH and the Hunger Games. And the son portrayed Jack Bauer. Bauer.
Yo, what's the dude Thor? What's his name? His brother's name? It's the dude that Liam Hemsworth. Is it Liam Hemsworth? It's the dude that dates that used to date Taylor Swift, but now he's with Jennifer Lawrence.
It's one of them.
It's Chris or Liam. I think it's Liam.
I don't know. I think he got it.
So are we going with
Liam Hemsworth? No.
Can you think of another person?
No, those are the only ones that I can remember from the. What's the kid that?
MASH and the Hunger Game. And the son portrayed Jack Bear. Bauer.
I don't even know.
What's the dude from that played in Journey to the Earth?
Quick, hurry up.
Forget his name. His face is there. Both their faces. I can't think of it.
The father played in MASH and the son was in Hunger Games.
No, the father did MASH and the Hunger Games.
Oh, the father did MASH and the Hunger Games.
Oh, yeah?
Oh, so you know the movie MASH that we keep watching on TV, your mother watches, right? And then and then the movie Hunger Games, I know you saw it. Just picture the same person in both of them. Do you know his name?
Is it the old dude that's the drunk that's in the movie, the one that's training her? That dude?
Yeah, I think so.
Is it Kiefer Sutherland?
Mm-hmm. So you got one right, so the last name stays. So that's the son. Yeah. That's the son. Kiefer Sutherland, yeah. Oh. And the father is something Sutherland. Donald Sutherland.
Donald?
Mm-hmm.
Who
names that
kid?
Donald Sutherland.
Donald?
No, Donald Sutherland.
Donald. Oh, all right.
Yeah, that's
right.
The father.
Oh.
Yeah, and you guessed the son. All
right.
So you got it anyways.
Worry. Now, let's see what y'all can do.
No.
Yo, I ain't gonna get these.
No.
I feel like I'm not even gonna get
the Sutherlands. Okay, so come and claim your gift. Where you going? Yeah. Where is it?
Help me out on this band shit.
We will. You know I know my music.
Oh. I clearly don't.
Riverside Cafe. I am so sorry. The gift that I mentioned is not here. But I have Faded Image. I have the Riverside Cafes. And I have
I'll do the Faded
Faded Image.
Just because I know you're
the one that needs it the most.
What, you were thinking of a haircut?
Yeah.
Aww. You could always come back to the studio and we can trade. All right, so who's my next
Dion,
person?
Dion, the melody.
All right, and we're doing kitchen, right?
Yep.
All right. Deep breath.
Let's go.
Okay, so kitchen category. Items you find in the kitchen.
All right.
Question number one. This item you use to marinate meat with. And the clue, you use it a lot during Thanksgiving too. Like to marinate the turkey and all. You use it a lot.
Gravy.
Is he trying to figure out the food?
No, the item.
The dish. Is it a castry dish?
Oh, yeah.
It's the glass dish. It's
yeah, I don't know the name of it, though.
What's the glass dish?
How about a turkey baster?
Yeah, turkey baster.
Yeah.
Yeah,
you use that to marinate the meat with. Yep. You use that
so
to marinate
that's
the
wrong, huh?
That's wrong, but it's okay. You know, you still have four questions to go. Right? Okay. Question number two. Little squeezable claws you use to pick up things like fried foods or to toss a salad.
Tongs.
Yeah, tongs.
Yes, you see?
Yep.
You can do this.
It's easy one.
Yeah. Okay, question number three. A slow cooker might remind you of an alligator.
Alligator.
A small cooker might remind you of an alligator.
A small cooker.
Think of a cooker. A small thing, and you can put all your ingredients in there, and you can make a meal. And let it do its thing.
Oh, oven.
Crock pot.
Oh, crock pot.
What are we going to go with? Is it crock pot?
Crock pot?
Crock pot,
yeah,
crock pot it is.
Right. Okay. You're supposed to know.
What, do you cook a lot?
Here and there?
Okay. Yeah. All right. So, question number three. Oh, no, sorry. Question number four. A portable bowl used to strain off liquid from food, especially after cooking.
Strainer?
Yeah. Yes, it is. Okay. Yeah, you got three right already. Do you want to just attempt the fourth question?
Yeah.
Okay.
Go ahead, Dylan.
The fifth question, yeah? A receptacle used for storing items which have no use anymore. You put things that you don't want anymore. And you have to empty it.
A trash can.
It is. So you went fine beyond.
Right. Are you gonna throw me under the bus? I can answer all your questions.
Okay. So what are we gonna go with? Do we want to do Cartland or do we want the Riverside Cafe? Cartland.
Yeah.
Okay. Actually, they're fun.
Yeah.
Okay. Oh my goodness. All right. Okay. Same ordeal. Five questions? Three right. Okay. The first one. Easy E, Ice Cube, Dr. Dre. Yes. Wow. Okay.
NWA,
right?
I was expecting something harder.
Oh, that's not hard. That could be a hard question for some people.
Mm-hmm.
Depends on the genre of music you listen to. Okay. Okay, I am so terrible to say these names. Okay, watch me screw up people's name.
That's okay.
Okay. Kurt Cobain. Dave Gore. I'm looking at my cameraman to criticize me. Chris.
Kurt Cobain was a rock and roll.
Yeah, I know. I just don't.
And then the last person is Chris Novoselic?
Kurt Cobain died.
Yeah.
Yes.
What?
Yes.
Nirvana?
Yes. No bad. Okay, third question.
Oh, the clutch one.
Ad Rock, Mike D, MCA.
You could Ad say Rock, Mike D, MCA?
Yes. So, do you recognize any of those people?
No.
Mike D, Ed Rock, Mike D, MCA. These were people, can you guess the band they, or a group that they represented?
Nope.
That's on the top of my head, too. I think I know. Oh, my God.
Like, okay, would you like to find out the answer?
Yes.
Okay. The Bestie Boys? Beastie Boys?
Wow. Yeah. That was some old school
Do you remember any of their songs?
Music.
Yeah?
I
I should have paid attention.
Okay. Fourth question. So how many did we get right? We got two right. So okay, we're only looking for one more. Just one more. Okay. Jake and Elwood Blues. And their group has the word blues in it too.
Blues Brothers.
Yes. So you actually won. Do you just want to attempt the last one? Yeah. Okay. 2D, Mel Doc, Nudo, and Russell.
2D, Mel Russell. Who else?
Nudo and Russell. How about gorillas? Do we know them? No.
I'm thinking about that's the hip hop group.
Yes.
Yeah, that's that.
Gorillas.
Yeah. That's with I think the black dude's the drummer. He's the nice drummer.
Do you remember any song they have sung?
Gorilla Zoe, I think. I don't remember any of this.
Gorilla Zoe. You talking about somebody.
So what kind of music do you listen the most?
I don't know.
You don't know the music you listen to?
I just listen
to it.
Oh. I just listen to whatever.
And whatever they're playing. Listening
yep.
to. Oh, okay.
I listen to whatever he listens to.
Oh, all right. But you did very well, either or. So.
Don't even let him front. Yo, he's like, he's a
kind of music over here.
Country music over here? Yeah. This is for you. Hello, this is Quinn Banda here from WCTV, and we are doing Street Talk again. This, I think it's episode number 9. So, yeah. We've been doing a great job so far, right? It seems like it.
Yeah.
Okay, so with me today is?
Stephen Sweeney.
Okay, and so you have picked the category of things or foods that begins with letter Q.
Yes.
How are you feeling?
I'm feeling good.
Okay, so same ordeal. 5 questions, 3 right.
Okay.
Okay, question number 1. To shake, also a part of a bow and an arrow. Or an arrow. Yeah, it begins with letter Q. To shake. Also, a part of a bow and an arrow. How many things fit that?
It's a hard one.
I see somebody thinking hard.
Yeah.
Begins with letter Q.
And it's on a bow or an arrow?
Yeah, also a part of a bow and an arrow.
Okay.
Anything that begins with letter Q, what are you thinking? none of them begins with letter Q. What are you thinking?
I was thinking like the tip of it, but that's called, I was going to say Q-tip, but that's a thing we are here.
Yeah.
So that's not it.
That's not it.
What are the feathers called on the bow?
Quills. Is that it? Is that the quills on the feathers on the bow?
Quiver?
Quiver?
Yes.
Yeah. No?
No.
I didn't get right? No, okay.
It's okay.
Okay.
It's okay. We have 4 more questions. Okay. Yeah, we have the whole day.
That would be if it's quiver, right?
Yes.
I said quill.
Oh, all right.
Oh, I see.
You were close,
yeah,
I
very
knew
close.
What it was.
Very
good.
Cool.
The word.
Yes. Yeah. Okay. Question number 2. A pacifist religious group that the draft does not apply to. They have their own oatmeal.
Quaker.
Yes. Do you eat it? Do you
I
eat
like
the
oatmeal?
Oh,
okay. I love oatmeal.
Quakers. Yeah. Yes.
Okay.
Okay. Question number 3. A line that you wait in. A line that you wait in. How do they say, instead of, they can say, instead of saying, telling you, oh, I get online or stand in line, they also can use another word which will mean the same thing. Stand in. It's the same sentence. So instead of saying, oh, get in line, or stand in line, or, you know, same a word that would mean this, would mean the same thing. Get in. When if I say it, you guys are gonna kick yourselves.
No, don't say it.
If I say it, you guys are gonna kick yourselves. Okay. It begins with the letter Q.
Quick.
Stand in a quick.
Get in line quick.
Get in line quick.
I think it just means a line.
A line?
Oh, the action of just standing in a line. If I say it.
I know, it's right there. I know, I got a feeling.
It begins with a letter Q. It kind of sounds like it. All right, guys, I have to give you the answer.
Yep.
In a queue. Get in a queue.
Get in a queue?
Yeah.
Is it really?
Yeah. Yes. That's You've crazy. Never heard of that?
No, I never heard of that.
No.
I never heard of
that. Oh.
In the queue. Wow. Yeah. You should have just said queue.
Queue. Okay. All right. So, question number 4. A Mexican girl's 15th birthday. This is a big celebration and they have a name for it. It's big in the Mexican culture.
Oh, man, I know. Quinceañera?
Yes!
Quinceañera.
Where are you pointing?
Tyven, because he went to a quinceañera not so long ago.
I like this. Okay, so we got 2 questions right.
Okay.
One more. Are you ready? Okay, to fight. It's another word.
Quarrel.
Yes.
Quarrel?
What are you gonna say?
I was gonna say quarrel.
Quarrel, yes! Quarrel. Okay, that was not hard.
It was not hard.
No, that was not hard at all.
The Q question
the
was Q, a little hard.
Yeah.
I mean, you got me stumped on that one, too. Yeah. I'm thinking, like, getting quarter, yay, getting something. I don't know. I was a little confused myself, but
well,
that was good.
Nowadays, then you can use it. Yeah. Sort of like getting in line, getting
yeah,
a cue.
Hey, getting cute.
Yeah, getting cute.
Okay, I'm going to use that.
Okay. Well, with that to say, thank you for participating. Here is a gift certificate to Liverside Cafe. You know where they are in Main Street?
I do.
Yes. So, and I believe they're open until noon, sometime in noon. So you have pretty much the whole morning. Right, to go and check them out.
Okay.
Okay, and when you go there, please let them know who sent you. That is WCTV.
Okay.
All right, thank
no
you.
Thank you.
How are you? My name's Stephen Bartlett. I just moved to Onset 2 months ago, and I see a lot of signs around there that says keep Onset clean. I love to keep Onset clean. I pick it up and I put it in a trash bag, but then I gotta go walk a million miles to find somewhere to put it. But if you guys had trash barrels around, I'm pretty sure it would be a lot cleaner than it is. So the only thing that I guess that I'd be asking for today is can we please put some trash barrels out there? Thank you. You have a great day.